then what we see from the numbers we've just looked at is 90% of advertising fails there. Better than 90% fails at impact, doesn't even get on the radar. 4% remember positively, 7% remember negatively, 89% not noticed or remembered. Everybody concentrates on the 7% that's remembered negatively. That's not the problem, at least that works. The 89% is the problem there. And yet all of our concentration, every bit of our concentration is down here on persuasion. We automatically assume everybody's going to see our ads. So we concentrate on focus groups, 12 women in slough, loads and loads of planners. We put all of our effort down there and wonder why 17 billion quid is pissed away. And a billion quid actually works. The people who are putting it now, why is that? If we know that, why is it like that? Okay, so the next bit I'll tell you, there's two ways to do this. There's the way it works for punters and the way it works for complicated way advertising people. We need two languages here, really, because we've got two consumers. Account men have got the clients as their consumers, and I've got housewives as my consumers. So once we were pitching for a supermarket, and I was with Mike Greenlees, and we were in there, and he said to the guy who owned the supermarket, in the middle of the pitch, he said, I see what your problem is. In order to increase stock turn, you need to optimise your on-shelf margins. And the guy said, fantastic, you've understood my problem. And we talked for a bit more. We walked out with the account. We got in the car park, and I said, what'd that mean, Mike? In order to increase stock turn, you need to optimise your on-shelf margins. And Mike said, well, if they make it cheaper, people will buy more. And I said, why didn't you say that? And Mike said, well, he won't give us the account, will he? We're asking a multi-million pound account. If I say to him, make it cheaper, Squire, and people will buy more, he won't give it to us. I've got to dress it up so it sounds like a lot of work. And I realised... He needs that language for his client, which is a concern, which is a client. He needs the credibility. And so I've learned that like I say, in briefs, the length of the language is inversely proportional to the quality of the thinking. People disguise bullshit with long words. I can't go on TV and have a presenter say to camera, ladies, in order to increase stock turn, we've optimised our on-shelf margins. I've got to say, ladies, in order to get you to buy it, we've made it cheaper. Cheaper than Asda, cheaper than Fine Fair. Yeah? That's my world. Because my consumers are housewives, but Mike's consumers are clients. So we need the two languages. So I'll give you this, the next bit, in two languages. First, I'll give you this in the consumer's language, how advertising works. I did this once 20 over years ago in Monte Carlo. And people still come up to me, at the time they didn't get it, but they still come up to me now and say that was the best thing they heard about. Media guys come up and say it's the best thing they heard about advertising. This is how it works. You won't like it, it's too simple. But this is how it works. This is a commercial break. For argument's sake, it's abstract. We're watching the TV, it comes on, end of part one. Here's the first commercial. Here's the second commercial. Here's the third commercial. Here's the fourth commercial, fifth commercial, sixth commercial, seventh commercial, eighth commercial, ninth commercial. Break's over, beginning of part two. We watch the rest of the program, we go to bed, we go to sleep, we get up in the morning, we go to work, in the evening we go to the supermarket. Which of those commercials is most likely to stick in our mind and not decay over that process? It's not rocket science. People don't like it because it's too simple. Now, that's how it is for consumers. They're not seeing whether one circle is better than another circle. What they're seeing is a load of circles and one X. So how does that work? We can't accept that. It's too simple. What you need to know is gestalt. If you ever know anything about gestalt, or if you've ever studied Freud, when we're born, we need to know how the mind works because that's our media. When you're born, you're in a state called id, and you move into a state called ego. Ego doesn't mean big-headed. Ego means I am. Ego is you learn to separate yourself off. When you're born, if you've got any children of your own, you watch them. They're in a state called id. Everything is everything. They don't even know there's a them that's separate to everything else, and they don't know other things are separate to each other. Gradually, they learn by grouping. The mind is a pattern-making machine. That's what Gestalt is about. Gradually, they learn by grouping. That lot's red, that lot's blue. That lot's up, that lot's down, that lot's left, that lot's like that. Selective perception is the quickest way to do it. If I do that, how many digits did I hold up? 10. You don't count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You say 2 hands, 5 each is 10. That's how the mind works. It creates patterns really fast. It's the only way you can deal with the plethora of information coming at you. The only way the mind can handle it. It happens so fast you don't even know it. Selective perception. If you, today all you see on the road are cars. You go home tonight, talk to the wife, and we decide we're going to buy a Volkswagen Golf. Tomorrow I come in and a quarter of all the cars on the road are Volkswagen Golfs. What happened? They appeared overnight? No, they were there, but previously they were just cars. Now I'm separating Golfs off from every other car. My mind. So what happens is, here's, from what we know there, this is your mind. Here's 19 commercials. 19 commercials. If I had another commercial, what share of your mind have I got in percentage terms? Come on, you're media guys. You do numbers. Right, if I had one more commercial, because they all look identical. But what, knowing what we know about the mind and knowing Gestalt and knowing pattern making is how the mind works, instantaneous pattern making, if I had another one that looks like that, what happens? I haven't got 5% because now I've got two groups in the mind. I've got everything that looks like that and everything that doesn't look like that. So now how much have I got? Without talking about being good, without fussing around with all this bit, I've gone straight away into the 10% that gets noticed. I've repositioned all the 90% just by being different. Now, of course, on its own, that's not good enough. But hey, that ain't a bad place to start. If you don't get noticed, you have absolutely no chance of working. Bill Birnbach said, if no one notices your advertising, everything else is academic.